Now we know why do you need A/B testing. The next question is, what can you A/B test? The good news is that, at least in theory, you can A/B test almost anything. In this course, of course, I will focus on online businesses, so I will bring most of my examples from that world, but with a little bit of creativity, you can run experiments even in the offline world. For a start, here's a simple example. Testing a landing page. This was Prezis, the company where I started as an intern back many years ago. So this was Prezis support page back in 2012. At that time, we experienced a pleasant issue. Our user base grew very, very fast. It was an issue because with the number of users, the number of support requests grew faster and faster too. So the support team started to create more and more tutorials, troubleshooting videos, and support articles, so the users can find the solution easier by themselves. When we released the new support page, we had two designs that we A/B tested. Version A came without a big HeroShot on the top. Version B came with HeroShot. So we wanted to create a design that helps people to find the self-serving troubleshooting guides and tutorials first. So our primary metric was to get less support tickets, and our second metric was the number of users who interacted with the tutorials, videos, and articles. What do you think? Which version won? Pause the video and try to figure it out. When I show this experiment in live workshops, I always get around half of the people vote for version A and the other half for version B, and that makes sense. In real life, you could argue for both versions. But that's the point of A/B testing, right? You don't have to figure this out. You test it and get feedback from user interactions. Okay, but here's the result. Version A has beaten version B. We got around 28% less support tickets from the version without the HeroShot. And on that version, we have seen people reading the articles and watching the videos around 18% more too. Version A was a clear winner. Why was that? Well, we don't know exactly, but our guess was that maybe on version B, people have seen the huge image and the search bar on the top, but they haven't realized that they can scroll for more content, so they searched and probably they haven't found what they were looking for. Maybe because they didn't put the right search phrases, or our internal search engine wasn't perfect at the time. Either way, they haven't found what they were looking for, and eventually they sent a support ticket instead. But on version A, people immediately have seen the search bar plus a few other options to find what they need. I mean, these are all theories, of course, but still, we have one important fact. Version A has won. What else can you A/B test? You can test headlines. You can test button colors or button text. You can test new features in your product. You can test prices. Although I have to mention here that this is considered a risky A/B test. Just imagine that someone sees $697 on her phone and her friend next to her sees $497. Not a great user experience, right? Many people also say that it's unethical to test prices. I don't find it unethical, but because of its complexity, I have never tried it. So I don't have too much hands-on experience with it, although I have a few friends who have run price A/B tests on their website, and they said that they had only a very few user complaints. Mostly nobody even realized it. With that said, if you go for it, be very careful with it. You can also test PPC ads. For instance, before I launched this course, I A/B tested its name using Facebook ads. I guess in this case, you know which version won this experiment. You can A/B test the name of new products. One famous example is Tim Ferriss's best-selling book, The 4-Hour Workweek. Great book, by the way. But in the book, Tim writes about how he came up with different variations for the title of the book. He put those variations into Google Ads and he measured which variation was clicked the most. So he got some information on which title would grab people's attention. You can also A/B test newsletter subject lines or even the content of your newsletters. And as I said, you can run experiments in the offline world as well. In fact, way before A/B testing was implemented to the online world, it was pioneered in medical research and it's still the gold standard research method. For instance, when they test a new medicine on humans, they select a treatment group who gets the real medicine and they select a control group who gets placebo. They compared the two groups and studied the effect of the real and the placebo drugs. That's really similar to online A/B testing. Of course, offline experiments have their unique challenges, but I think that they were the inspiration for the online A/B tests that we use today. One more offline example. This was my offline A/B test back in 2013. I put QR code stickers into bar toilet stalls. I had different headlines on them. I put these into men's and women's room, and eventually I measured which one was scanned the most. These were the stickers, by the way, and no surprise that the most scanned stickers, both for men and women, were sex. They say sex sells, but I have evidence for it too. One last comment, there are some very specific A/B testing examples where you should consider ethical aspects as well. This is very rare, but for instance, Facebook got a lot of backlash for one of its A/B tests back in 2014. They were researching human emotions, more specifically for a small portion of their audience. They set up a variation of their original newsfeed where they prioritized the posts of the user friends with more negative sentiments. In another variation, for another small segment, they prioritized the posts with more positive sentiments. And the large control group got their original neutral newsfeed. Their experiment showed that people who see more negative posts post more negative things themselves, and it was true the other way around. People who see more positive posts post more positive things. That was all interesting, that's true. But when they published their research, they got a lot of criticism that they literally played with people's emotions, which is, you know, not very ethical. Also, in some extreme cases, it can push people into depression or even worse. I don't want to be all dramatic here, and obviously this Facebook experiment is only one out of the million, but the point is that sometimes you have to consider ethical aspects of running experiments as well. Anyway, I hope these examples help you to see that you can A/B test almost anything you can think of. It's much easier to get it done in the online world, especially if you are running an online business, but it's not impossible in the offline world either.